yin and acceptance for where we are right now and what's going on. So there's three principles with the practice of yin. The first principle is to come into the pose at an appropriate depth. So we don't want to use the body to get into the pose. We want to use the pose to get into the body. So as we get into each pose throughout this class, we want to settle at an appropriate depth, meaning we're not trying to force ourselves to go in. The second principle is to resolve to remain still. Now this can be really challenging. You might want to fidget, or you feel like there's things that are surfacing emotionally or mentally that make you want to move. But resolving to remain still is our commitment to stay, to breathe, and to be. Now there's two exceptions to this rule. First exception is if you're in pain. Now we have to distinguish the difference between pain and discomfort. Something just feels uncomfortable, and you try to quiet your mind and listen to why it feels uncomfortable and breathe and stay. If there's pain, then take the appropriate adjustment that you need. The second reason to move is that as we stay in these poses anywhere from 1 to 5 minutes, if there's an invitation and the body starts to open, then it'll naturally allow you to go deeper. Third principle with yin is to hold the pose for time. And the reason we do this with yin is that it's the tissue is different than when we're exercising regularly, like with the vinyasa practice or we're doing exercise. The tissue that we're working through is actually much deeper than the superficial layer of the muscles. They're a lot deeper in the fascia and the connective tissue. So the reason we hold these tissues, we hold these poses for a very long time is that it allows us to go deeper and to start to create openness and fluidity in those joints. So, there we go. Let's get started. So, we're going to come onto our feet. We're going to come onto our shins and knees. So if you have any knee issues, then you can take the blanket underneath and just create a nice little appropriate space here. Now I'm going to turn to the side for a moment so you can see me. So your feet, your toes are going to be tucked. And so you're on the balls of your feet, and you're going to feel a really deep stretch across the soles of your feet, across the arches. You want to make sure that your lower back is slightly tucked down towards your heels, and that your low ribs are drawing in. Let your palms come onto your thighs, let your shoulders drop back and down, and close your eyes and begin to settle in. Allow your first few breaths to just feel natural and peaceful as you're settling into yourself this morning. relax your jaw, relax the muscles of your face. Take three more breaths. Feels too uncomfortable. your third breath, gently start to elevate the chest as you walk your hands up and back. If you have any prop in front of you, place it off to the side. Bring your hands behind you with your fingertips facing forward and start to extend one leg and then the other coming onto the heels. From here, a little counter pose to push off the legs. Press into the hands, lift the hips, and then start to elevate, coming into reverse plank. You can keep the chin tucked towards the chest, or if it feels comfortable, you can lift the head up or even drop it all the way back. Take three gentle breaths. Slowly start to draw the chin towards the chest, lowering the hips back down. Draw one knee in. We're going to turn all the way down into the mat, coming onto all fours. So if you need some support for your knees, you can place your blanket underneath the knees. We're going to separate the knees about 50 cents, coming onto the balls of the feet. Okay, a couple options here. So the hips stay elevated, and we start to lower the arms down. And then we start to bring either the forehead towards the ground, create a nice stretch in the upper and middle back. If this is too intense, a couple options. You can either, if it's intense in the shoulders, you can bring the arms out wide, even bending the elbows, bringing the forearms down. You can also take the blanket and bring it forward, or the pillow, bring it forward. You can either come onto the chin or drop one ear to the ground. You can go to that gentle, easy breath. Can you allow yourself to really feel at home in your body? And be grateful for the home that you have. And during this time, it's easy to focus on all the things that we don't have. How can we take it as simple as finding gratitude for the home that we live in, the gift of the body that was given to us? Allow your breath to wash over that thankfulness.
And to keep the blanket underneath your knees,
or you can again place that off to the side as well.
And all the way onto the belly, you're going to come onto the forearms. So we want the shoulder to line right up, evenly with the elbows. Now, if you feel any tightness in your low back, option here is to bring the feet out nice and wide. Okay. And so as you gently press into the forearms, to elevate the chest, drop the shoulder blades back. And now we're going to soften and drop the head towards the ground. Be mindful that, again, yin is about healing. So it's not about going super deep and being active in the pose. There are certain muscles and body parts that are engaged, but it's about softening everything around the muscles. So imagine that your bones are softening into yourself. You can breathe into the body in a way that calms, surrenders. You are watching this on YouTube, the recorded version of this. You are welcome at any point to pause if you want to stay longer in each pose. If silence is a little intense and challenging for you, there will also be a link underneath the YouTube video for a playlist that I've made that accompanies this class. You're welcome to listen to on Spotify. Take two more breaths. After your next exhale, gently come down onto the belly. Create a pillow with your hands. Lower your right ear down onto your hands. And then bend your left knee and bring the knee up towards the left shoulder. And relax both shoulders and try to relax your low back and your sit bones. Thank you.
two more breaths. Do your final breath slowly. Start to bend the elbows. Come all the way back down onto the belly. Create a cone with your hands. Maybe take your opposite hand on top. And this time lower the left ear down onto the hand and start to draw the right knee up towards the right elbow. Softening the shoulders, softening the sit bones. And relax.
slide the right leg back. Start to walk the hands underneath your shoulders and gently press up onto hand and knees. Again, supporting the knees if you need to with a blanket underneath. Moving into tabletop position. So knees are separated, hip distance apart, hands a little wider than hip width, about shoulder width. And then spin the elbow creases forward. I'm just taking a few gentle rounds through cat-cow. Inhaling as you drop the belly, let the gaze come forward as the collarbones widen. Exhale, press into the hands, chin to chest as you round. And take this really slow. So even more slow than normal. Take one more full cycle. And then gently coming back to a neutral spine. Coming on to the backs of the feet. Swing the hips over to one side and then sweep the legs all the way around. So bring both knees together, knees pointing towards the right. Mermaid pose. And now we're going to take the left leg and start to draw it back. Okay, so options here with the legs. Having the feet closer in together, it's going to be a little bit easier on the knee joints. If it's available to you and you'd like to go a little deeper, you can start to bring the feet a little further away. So drawing that right foot forward and that left leg back. And we're going to grab either our bolster, blanket, cushion, whatever you're using, and you're going to bring it over next to your right. From here, we're going to start to twist over to the right. So you might stay right here. Right fingertips coming like a kickstand as the left arm reaches across the right thigh and just finding a gentle twist. And again, you can drop the head, chin towards the chest to relax. To go a little deeper still, maybe you start to walk the hands all the way down. And so you're turning your chest and your belly onto that blanket or cushion. And either bringing the chin down or you can drop your right ear down. Another option still here is to take a block underneath the bottom part of that cushion or bolster. So it's a little bit more elevated if coming all the way down isn't available so that you can lower the chest and lower all the way down. Let your belly relax, let your shoulders soften down your back, even let your feet and ankles relax as well. rhythmic breath, the more it allows us to move out of the fight or flight, the sympathetic nervous system, into the parasympathetic nervous system. We move further into trusting, yielding, letting go, and stepping away from fear and anxiety and stress for what we don't know. Take two more breaths. And gently start to lift yourself back up if you're ready. Slowly start to release. Bring in the hands behind you as you start to draw both feet now forward. And we'll take a little windshield wipers with the knees. So just dropping the knees from side to side. Again, paying attention as you move slowly. One more full round of breath through each side. And then dropping the knees now all together over to the left. Take the right leg and bring it behind you. Same variations here. You can have the feet closer together or further apart. If you have any props on the other side, you can bring them over now to the left. Taking your left fingertips out behind you at the kickstand, take the right arm across onto the right thigh. An option as you lift up your chest to find a gentle twist over to the left shoulder. Or if it's available and you'd like to start to lower down, continue turning the chest and the belly as you fold forward. And if it helps, imagine that your breath is a prayer. And so as you breathe the breath within you, feel it breathe in, circle out and around you, and sending that prayer, encompassing you and encompassing everyone that's going through the same thing right now. One of the benefits of this practice is that it's not just for us. It allows us to show up and be a better person with our families, with our children, with our communities. And that gives us strength to be able to lift and carry one another in times like this, in times of stress and suffering. Back to that internal space of love and of appreciation for what we have. And we really need it.
yourself facing the moon lengthwise on your mat, and we'll come all the way down onto our backs. And so as you're lower down to your back, you're going to start to walk the heels over towards the right, and then take the left ankle, cross it over top of the right. Okay, arms are going to come overhead, and we're going to start to lean the upper body, so sliding the arms over to the right. Now you can either grab your hands or grab opposite wrists, let your left hand grab your right wrist, or you can grab opposite elbows. So essentially we're making the shape of a banana. Letting that left shoulder drop and relax. Begin to breathe into the space between the ribs and the intercostal muscles. Feeling an opening from your IT band all the way through the side waist, up through your ribs. Allow your body to be heavy, sinking upon the earth. If you've lost that connection to the equal ratio breath, begin to invite it back in. Softly breathing, softly noticing. Taking two more breaths. And gently releasing the arms, uncross the left ankle, and begin to walk or slide the feet back to center, and then continue to walk the ankles now over to the left, taking the right ankle over top of the right, or the right ankle over top of the left, and then starting to lean the upper body towards the left, towards the feet. You're grabbing wrists or opposite elbows here, let your right shoulder be heavy, feeling that open quality through the right side waist, through the right IT band, and the intercostal muscles of the ribs as you breathe. gently release the arms, uncross the right leg. Start to walk the heels back to center. And then you one knee at a time, taking the knees into the chest. And just wrap your arms around your shins, feel the back of your head, and your low back pressing into the earth. And just breathe here and notice. The light and the peace and the joy and the ease that you feel in your body now. And silently you say thank you. Thank you to your body. Thank you to the God of your understanding. Thank you to this life. And as you release the arms, we're going to come into variation of Shavasana for our rest. So if you have a wall nearby, you're welcome to start to make your way towards the wall. If there's not a wall, I'm going to show you that variation first. So staying where you are, bringing the feet nice and wide, just let the knees drop in. Let your low back settle, feel your low back press into the ground, feel your spine connect to the ground, and let your palms rest facing up at your side. Maybe even draw one shoulder blade under and then the other to feel the chest open and relax. And then settle here. If you're near a wall, you're going to make your way towards the wall facing it, bringing your feet off to the side, and then scooting the legs all the way up. And so to make yourself closer towards the wall, you can press into the hands and kind of slide or scoop yourself so you're coming as close to the wall as you can. Letting the legs rise all the way up, and letting the arms come at your sides facing up. If the knees bend slightly, that's okay. If the feet turn out, that's fine. Just really let your spine rest into the ground. Let the shoulders be heavy. Let your face relax. And now let the breath trail off. Easy and natural. As you rest. gently begin to bring your awareness back into your body, back into your breath. Begin to deepen the breath. If your knees are bent, gently start to extend one leg and the other, reaching your arms overhead. If your legs are up the wall, gently start to reach the arms overhead, slowly bending one knee and then the other. Start to press into your hands, peeling yourself back up to seat.